It is an attack on North American weather. The weather is being manipulated from outside of the country. The hurricane that slammed into New Orleans was guided in there. So was the Hurricane Rita and Gaston and some of the others. We believe that the Russian systems that have been developed since the late 50s, early 60s in Russia is the ultimate weapon, and we have no defenses against it. It's called Scalar. That's a modern name for the systems. Scalar weapons. There are three divisions of Scalar coming against America. One is called energetics, and one is called bioenergetics, and one is called psychoenergetics. The psycho function can actually manipulate mind thoughts, personalities, and cause astronaut Lisa to wear a diaper driving across the country.
Really?
That kind of thing. Yes. There was an admiral on an aircraft recently that stood up and said to everybody on the plane that he had smallpox, and they took him off the plane. He was in medicine. That was psychoenergetics. It's functions on the mind and mind functions. You can actually insert another personality in the person. The bio comes against living bodies, their biochemistry. And the energetics can come against the Challenger, the Columbia, the Thresher submarine, where 129 men died. Those were, we believe, we are sure they were attacks by Russian scalar weapons.
Now, can you just help us understand? That's a big title. Atmospheric Sensitivity and Validation Study of the Variable Terrain Radio Parabolic Equation Model. What is, sir, and I have to, excuse me for asking this, but what is VTRPE?
It is a subprogram, a computer program within the Radio Frequency Mission Planner system that's key to battlefield operations. It is key. We cannot fight wars without that. We've come to that. As in World War II, you put a man in the field with a gun and say, go shoot him, you know. But today's military operates by a satellite and ground radar. So this system ties into satellite radar and ground radar, and that VTRPE can paint a three-dimension battlefield image over land terrain from a ship 200 miles in the Atlantic or the Pacific.
All right, so you say originally it was done to get this three-dimensional battlefield imaging for warships and then for battlefields. Now, how does that translate into something that's going to be negative for our health, though?
You're using barium salt and other DARPA aerosols. You're primarily using a mixture of barium salts to make it work over land terrain adequately, accurately.
And there are some serious negative effects using barium, and of course a lot of that information is at carnicom.com. What else do you see as being a problem of doing? Now, you're saying that this was an allegedly somewhat innocuous program to try and just do battlefield imaging.
That's how it started. Then DARPA got into it, and other agencies got into it, and God only knows where it is now and what's coming out of those planes. You see, I tried to paint a picture hurriedly of the Iranian-Contra, which was a CIA operation, and this pretty much is a CIA Navy operation. You're dealing with people, you don't know who they are, they're not accountable to anybody, they're capable of dastardly things. You see, the American people are totally out of the loop. Their reality is based on their life experience. The way you judge things and the way you process things, your opinions are based on your own life experience. Most people haven't had these experiences.